Hi, I'm Mike Simon with the Denver Outlaws, Brian Athlete, and today I'm here to talk to you about defending for midfield. The fundamentals of defending a midfielder as a long stick middie is forcing them to their weak hands or forcing them down alleys. What we're going to talk about today is primarily how to force guys in the direction that we want them to go. And then on top of that, I'll show you some of the things that I do in the MLL that make me an effective long stick middie. First and foremost, whenever you're coming out to meet a midfielder, you want to make sure that you're going to restrict him from going wherever he wants. If the guy is a right-handed player, we may still want to force him to his right hand as long as we can keep him going down the alley. As I approach a midfielder up top, the first thing I want to do is make sure my hands are in good position. I'm going to have my stick out in front where I'm in a position to check into his gloves or possibly knock down a pass if he wants to move the ball. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure my hips are square to the sideline if I'm trying to force him down an alley. Once we've made a midfielder pick a hand and choose a side, it's important to keep him going in that direction. So by trailing the midfielder only slightly, staying on his back shoulder, if the midfielder tries to roll back to the middle of the field, I'm still in good position to prevent him from getting to the middle. I have with me today Tony Rossi. He's a midfielder for Stevenson University this year, and he's one of the best midfielders in Division III. He's going to be walking through some of the defensive work that I'm going to be showing you today. So the first thing that I'm going to do when I'm coming out to play Tony is I'm going to be working on my approach angle. Definitely want to limit him from being able to go wherever he wants on the field. In this case, I'm going to try to force Tony to his right hand. As I approach Tony, I'm going to come up, I'm going to square my hips to the sideline, and I'm going to probably line my middle of my body up with his back shoulder. If I step too far downfield, Tony will still have the ability to sweep across the field if he chooses to do so. One of the things that I like to tell my young defensemen is you never want to commit your hips until he commits his. Everything Tony is going to do prior to committing to where he's going to go is designed to try to get me to open my hips before he commits his. For example, if he's coming at me and he makes a hard move and I get my hips open, but he didn't commit his fully, he's going to have the ability to go to the middle of the field and beat me. So instead, it's important to be disciplined, keep my hips square, wait till Tony makes his move, and now I can run and play with it. All right, so now the thing is, after Tony has started his dodge down the alley, I'm going to trail Tony just slightly so that at any point, if he tries to roll back to the middle of the field, I'm still in good position to keep him where I want him. Then if you force him again and he continues to go right-handed, I'm still in good position to run and potentially throw checks and keep him from scoring. As a long stick middie in the MLL, one of my strengths as a defenseman is getting out and playing guys. So instead of forcing a guy down an alley, I like to play players a little bit more straight up. I use my length and speed to make the guy have to run around me, and then I can match feet with him and catch up. Once again, this is Mike Simon with the Denver Outlaws and Brian Athlete sharing with you about defending up at midfield.